Sony Mobile is well known for slapping some seriously smart camera tech onto its handsets, but what about the wallet-friendly, affordable Xperia L2? Does this still impress with its snapping skills, despite lacking some of those more premium features that we're used to from Sony? Here's our full Xperia L2 camera review. The freshly launched Xperia L2 is one of Sony's most budget-level blowers right now. As a result, the 13-megapixel rear camera and 8-megapixel front facer are quite stripped back, compared with most premium Xperias. Dive into that camera app and you will immediately be in familiar territory, at least if, of course, you've used a Sony handset before. The general layout is basically the same, but straight away, you'll notice some of those missing features. So for instance, you don't get a superior auto mode, it's just a standard auto mode. And it basically does as expected, though it isn't quite as smart at determining the best settings for a particular environmental conditions. Oh yeah, and you'll have to make full use of that on-screen shutter button, as well as there's no dedicated shutter button here on the side of the phone, something that you get from the more premium Xperia devices. Alternatively, the phone does also serve up a bit of smile shutter action. If you dive down into the auto capturing, it's right there, and that basically operates as expected, although there is a bit of a lag at times, so if you've got a kid who smiles all too briefly, you might find you missed that golden moment. If you happen to be a photography enthusiast, then good news, you can just flick up to that manual mode and this gives you full settings, full control over the likes of your white balance, ISO levels, all that kind of stuff, so you can get exactly the kind of shot that you want. And alternatively, if you flick up to the video mode, then you can shoot up to full HD 30 frames per second resolution video. Sadly, there is no option for 60 frames per second, or of course full 4K as you get on those more premium handsets. You'll have to jump up to the Xperia XA 2, which costs 299 quid if you want a bit of that. And sadly, there's no slow motion feature either, so you can't shoot those really good looking slow motion videos. Shoot away in decent daylight conditions and you can expect some reasonably detailed results. Colours are well captured and naturally reproduced. So if you're shooting a vibrant subject, the end results will often be quite attractive. However, we did have some trouble capturing moving subjects at times. With typical artificial lighting and in dim conditions, our photos of pets and offspring almost always came out a little bit blurred. And likewise, the Xperia L2 often struggles with imperfect lighting. The wide dynamic range usually results in murky or oversaturated photos, so you'll want to avoid shooting against bright backgrounds. And in low light, you can expect hazy colours and plenty of grain unless you use that flash. Not much of a shocker considering the budget price point. Around the front of the Xperia L2, you get an 8-megapixel selfie shooter to capture your best hench face at any one time. This boasts a wide angle feature which can be manually activated to capture loads of background at the same time. However, this front facer suffers from the same shortcomings as the main camera. Once again, tricky lighting conditions will throw it off every time. And if you're in a dimly lit bar or some other low light environment, you might as well forget it. With no kind of screen flash feature on board, the L2 almost always returns murky snaps. The video recording experience on the Xperia L2 is about as stripped back as it comes. There are practically no features here to speak of, not even Sony's trademark steady shot image stabilization. It is basically simply a case of point and shoot and see what you end up with. Still, video quality is pretty much standard for an affordable Android. Detail levels are fine when viewing back on a smaller display, though the picture can get quite blocky when you do beam it to a TV. The lens also needs a little bit of time to adjust when the focal distance changes, even with object tracking enabled. Likewise, you won't want to move around too much when filming. While we've seen far shaky results from budget blowers, the Xperia L2 doesn't offer much in the way of image stabilization. Again, for a budget blower, it's perfectly acceptable. You can't expect wonders here. You can check out that full video sample right here on Recombu's YouTube channel and don't forget to head to recombu.com for our in-depth review complete with more photo samples. Thanks for watching everyone, give us a like and a subscribe and ding that old notifications bell, why don't you? Cheers.